Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let us begin with our prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I come before you asking for forgiveness of all my sins, O God, that you cleanse me with your precious blood so that you may receive this prayer in your holy throne. I thank you, O God, for this opportunity to come before you, for this faith that you have given us, to bow on our knees, O God, and to raise our hands and praise you, O Lord, and bless your name in gratitude, O God, for the life that you have given us through your Son, Jesus Christ, because you have made us new by your Holy Spirit, who guides us, who teaches us, who transforms us, O Lord. Who else other than you, Creator of the universe, the Almighty Lord? Thank you, O Lord, because you have revealed yourself to us and you have given us this privilege, this precious and incomparable gift, O God, of that beautiful faith to believe in you, to accept you, O Lord, and to live a new life according to your will for your glory and honor, O God. I thank you because just as this day is the beginning of a new week, you have given us new life, O Lord, and I bless you. I thank you, O Lord, and I ask, O God, that this day as well, you use me, O Lord, as an instrument, that you bless this ministry, all the ones who are involved in everything that we do, that you bless us, that you guide us, and that you let us be instruments in your hands for your glory. And that all those who receive your word, may they be strengthened and fortified in you, O God. May their faith be greater each day and their gratitude deeper each day, O God. I ask that you bless the two congregations of this day as well, that you help them with all their needs and issues, O God, and that you fill them with joy, knowing that it is you who guides them and who will protect them and who will continue to aid them, O God, in this path of holiness and righteousness, O God, preparing all your church for that glorious day, for your glorious return. O God, bless the leaders of our church. Make us faithful to you, O God, obedient to your word. And remember all those, O God, who are no longer perhaps in your ways, who have strayed, O God, but we know and we ask with all the hope and faith that you will do a work in their hearts, and one day we will rejoice in seeing their return, O God. Thank you for this new day, for this new week. I ask that you guide us, that you fortify us, O Lord, that you protect us, O God, and that you keep us very near to your heart and allow us to be always filled by your holy presence and your grace. O God, give us the victory, because in Jesus' name I have asked all these things. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Thank You Because You Are Returning For Me. It was written by Migdalia Ayala and translated by Maria Elena Cardona. This devotional comes from the book Mesa de Fe, page 50. Our biblical base is found in the book of Revelations, chapter 22, verses 6 through 15. So says the word of God. Then he said to me, These words are faithful and true. And the Lord God of the holy prophets sent his angel to show his servants the things which must shortly take place. Behold, I am coming quickly. Blessed is he who keeps the words of the prophecy of this book. Now I, John, saw and heard these things. And when I heard and saw, I fell down to worship before the feet of the angel who showed me these things. Then he said to me, See that you do not do that, for I am your fellow servant and of your brethren the prophets and of those who keep the words of this book. Worship God. And he said to me, Do not seal the words of the prophecy of this book, for the time is at hand. He who is unjust, let him be unjust still. He who is filthy, let him be filthy still. He who is righteous, let him be righteous still. He who is holy, let him be holy still. And behold, I am coming quickly, and my reward is with me, to give to everyone according to his work. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Blessed are those who do his commandments, that they may have the right to the tree of life and may enter through the gates into the city. But outside are dogs and sorcerers and sexually immoral and murderers and idolaters and whoever loves and practices a lie. Amen. May we be blessed through the reading of his holy word. Thank you because you are returning for me. Many great events have occurred in the universe, but we await a greater one, that is, the second coming of Jesus Christ, when each of his children will say, "Thank you because you come for me, Jesus. Thank you that you will take me to your holy dwelling, the heavenly city where the redeemed will live." There in heaven, the Lord Jesus has prepared eternal dwellings for us. There, we who have been washed with the precious blood that he shed on the cross, the blood of the Holy Lamb of God, will live. I want to see my King, and I am getting ready to be in his presence. I will look at him face to face and surrender at his feet. I want to say, "Holy, holy, holy, and thank you for coming for me." Before that glorious day arrives, I want to live here on earth doing your will, O God, busy in salvation with fear and trembling, attentive to all that the Holy Spirit is demanding to be right with you. I want to live in communion with God, praying, watching, recognizing the one who is worthy and deserves all adoration. I want to bow down in prayer and say, "Lord, thank you that you come for me." Amen. All glory to God. As a child, I looked forward to the weekend because it meant no school, which meant sleeping in, my favorite. But I was also accustomed to the rush of the preparations for the Sabbath, and I enjoyed going to church to sing and be with everyone, and I thank God, and I praise his name for this beautiful upbringing. But at that time, I had not had a personal encounter with him yet, until one Sabbath, during a sermon, by his mercy, I felt the calling and the desire to baptize. My journey with God had begun long ago, but my relationship with him was born that day, and by the grace of my Lord, it has developed and deepened. Like Paul said, "When I was a child, I spoke, I understood, and thought like a child. Now, I so ardently wait for the weekend, grateful for that setting sun on Friday, knowing that the week of work and stress and constant distractions is over. The Sabbath is here, and now I can rest in his holy presence. After a difficult week, I can find comfort and peace in his holy day. After a battling week, I can be renewed by his showers of grace. After a week of victory, I can testify and proclaim his goodness." Of course, this doesn't mean that I live every other day ignoring my spiritual life and only seeking God when I physically go to church. Definitely not. But there is a difference in the Sabbath, and his word confirms it by telling us that he sanctified it, which means that he set that day apart and consecrated that day as a special day, as a day that we could rest physically because he knew that we would need it, but most importantly, spiritual rest, because it is a day entirely dedicated to him. No work, no worldly matters, no excuses, but instead a day of worship in spirit and truth, wholeheartedly and mentally committed to enjoy his holy day. We're quote-unquote, giving up this day, but in reality, we are the ones who are blessed by being in His presence. Our souls are rejuvenated and revitalized in Him, and all of this is just a snippet, a taste, a foreshadow of what it will be like to live eternally by His side. But if we are not even willing to commit to this one day of absolute praise, how could we then spend eternity doing that? And yes, there is a promise that we will be transformed to perpetually worship Him, but His word teaches us that the Lord declared, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord." This scripture is an analogy of what the heavenly kingdom is like. If we are faithful to God and devoted to living a holy life to fulfill His will, even in the smallest things, then surely in Jesus' name, we will rejoice in hearing our Father welcome us into His glorious dwellings. Instead of a week of work, we will leave behind this life of earthly matters, and no longer limited by our humanity, we will enter His eternal Sabbath, where everything will be peace and joy through His Holy Spirit, where we will be part of that choir that sings His praises forever and ever. I pray every day asking God to help me live that life worthy of being His daughter, a life that He approves, and a life that will allow me to see His face one day, to see the one who loved me, to thank the one who gave His life, to give me mine, and to adore the Holy and Almighty One who conquered my heart.
For the Lord, Jesus is coming soon. Call back the sinner, wake up the saint. Let every nation shout of your fame. Yes, Jesus is coming soon. Jesus, come. So come, Lord Jesus, come.
The excitement of a bride getting ready to present herself to her husband, the longing to be joined to her loved one, and the joy of walking down the aisle to become one with her husband. These are the resulting feelings of being in love. May our Lord be glorified for winning over our hearts. But if you haven't felt this, today is your opportunity to open your heart to Him so that all together, in gratitude for His revelations, for the path to salvation, and for the promise that He is coming back to take us home, let us passionately strive to be that church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such things, but that is holy and without blemish, a church ready for His glorious return. Amen. But before we finalize this session, I kindly invite you to go over to our YouTube channel, SEC English Ministry, for our daily Bible readings so we may be filled with joy as we read God's promises. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of His children, now and forever. Amen. Have a joyful day.